Hey friends, I was just saying hi in Morse code. You know, before the telegraph, messages were handwritten and carried on horsebacks. I'm glad I have this telegraph that led to one of the greatest inventions. You must have guessed it's the Morse code. Let's find out some more. Zoom in. This is Samuel Morse, an art professor at the New York University. He always had a soft corner for science. One day, Samuel Morse received news which was urgent, long after the event had occurred. He had lost out on bidding farewell to someone really dear, and this made him very furious. Unhappy with the communication system, he began thinking of ways to transfer messages in an instant from one place to another. And he finally created the telegraph. A communication system that transmitted electric signals over wires from location to location and then translated into a coded message. He used pulses of current to deflect an electromagnet, which moved a marker to produce written codes on a strip of paper. In 1837, Samuel Morse gave the first demonstration of his invention in a university classroom. His single-circuit telegraph worked by putting the operator key down to complete the circuit. The other side received the same electric signal and had to decode it. Inspired by this invention, a young man named Alfred Vail offered his assistance to improve the design. The device was then modified with Vail's idea to emboss the paper with dots and dashes. Vail created a new code system, where going through hundreds of pages to read a message was avoided. To assign alphabets to these symbols, they counted the number of times every alphabet occurred in newspapers. They found that the alphabet E was the one to occur the most. So they assigned it the simplest of the symbol, a dot. This continued for the rest of the alphabets. And that's how an art professor invented the first machine to send and receive messages instantly. Wait on, I have more coming up for you. Trivia time! Did you know, in spite of all the technology, the upgraded version, which is the International Morse Code, is used even today to navigate planes and naval ships? Morse code is also used by people who are differently abled, as they sometimes use the motion of their eyelashes to send messages across by fluttering their eyes for every dot and closing their eyes for a second for every dash. Well, I hope the message sent today was clearly received and well understood. Oh, do you hear that emergency distress signal? I better go help. See you next time, friends. This is me zooming out. Hey kids, you liked my videos, didn't you? Before you go, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and the bell, so you won't miss out on my latest videos. See you.